Welcome to the fourth video of the web-based application programming for the IoT applications. In this video, I will be talking about the analog to digital converter, or in short, ADC. The ADC is used in most of microcontroller systems and digital control systems. After that, we will learn together about how to write some program in JavaScript to get some sensor data from the ADCs of the microcontroller. And then we will display them in the web browser using the gate or meter component. As always, before we go into the programming section, let's take a look at the fundamentals of the electronic devices and electronic circuits. Well known in the electrical and electronic circuits, there are three basic parameters. The first one is resistance, the second one is voltage, and the last one is current. As we already know in the basic circuit analysis, these three main parameters in any circuit can be explained by the Ohm's laws. And we know that in the real-world applications, most of the environment parameters can be converted into the electrical parameters using some specific sensors. The output of the sensors can be resistance, voltage, or current. They are depend on the specification of those sensors. For instance, the light intensity can be converted into resistance using LDR or light dependent resistor. The wide range temperature can be converted to the resistance using RTD or resistance temperature detector. We can use a thermocouple to convert the temperature to resistance. In the real world applications or the industrial applications, however, the outputs of all types of the sensors must be converted to the specific voltage or current. For example, 1 volt to 5 volt or 4 to 20 milliamps. The circuit that's used to convert the sensor output to the appropriate output is called the signal conditioning circuit. Now, moving into our system, the digital computer or the microcontroller systems, all of the output parameters of the sensor, including resistance and the current, will be converted into a proper range of the voltage by the signal conditioning circuit. And the output voltage of the signal conditioning circuit will be converted again into the digital data using the special converter called analog to digital converter, in short, ADC. Before moving into the details of the analog to digital converter, or the ADC, firstly, let's talk about the analog signals. Generally, the analog signal is measured by a sensor. For example, we can use a flow sensor to measure the flow rate of the liquid in our system. In this case, the flow rate in the pipe. If the output of the flow rate sensor is the voltage value that related to the flow rate, we will get a signal like this. The voltage waveform is continually changes over time. It depends on the flow rate in the pipe. As we have known, the sensor gives us the voltage as analog signal or analog data. We need to process this analog signal in our computer to do something useful. To do so, we have to send the signal to our digital computer and ask a CPU in computer to process that data. Unfortunately, we cannot send that analog signal to the CPU directly because the CPU is digital device and it knows only digital data. To convert the analog signal or analog data to the digital data and give it to our CPU, we need an analog to digital converter or ADC. With this setup now, the CPU can perform that data received from our sensor. As you may know, with the microcontroller technologies today, no extra devices are needed to make our system work because all modules that we need are embedded in a single chip device, so called the microcontroller, or in short, MCU. Now, let's move into the details of the ADC. Remember, there are four main things here. The first one is the sensor that converts physical parameter to an electrical parameter. The second one is the signal conditioning circuit that converts the electrical parameter to a proper voltage, for example, 0 to 5 volts or 0 to 3.3 volts. The third one is the main important part of the microcontroller systems, the ADC. It converts an input voltage to the digital data before sends to the CPU or another digital data processing circuit. The last one is the CPU. The CPU takes the data sent from the ADC and processes that data to find desired result. Once again, all digital parts of our system, including the ADC and the MCU, are embedded in a single chip of microcontroller. And we know, the output of the ADC is digital data. The digital data is composed of the sequence of bits. Here are some examples of the n-bit ADC. Start from 2-bit ADC, and it is a 3-bit ADC, and here is 4-bit ADC. And the bigger one here, 10-bit ADC. There is no limitation in the numbers of the bit here. But in the microcontroller applications today, the most ADC is 10-bit or 12-bit. However, in some microcontrollers, the internal ADC can be up to 16-bit, 24-bit, or 32-bit. Now, let's take a look closely into the 2-bit ADC. The 2-bit ADC has four different output values. 00 is 0, 01 is 1, 10 is 2, and finally the 11 is 3. Only four steps here are used to represent the input voltage from the minimum value to the maximum value. The same idea for the 3-bit ADC. The outputs of the 3-bit ADC are 8 different values. Start from 000 to 111, where the 000 represent the minimum value and the 111 represents the maximum value. Now let's see how it works. How the ADC 3-bit work. We have here the input voltage. This input voltage can be represented by each values or each steps. It starts from 0 to 7 like this. We can get that input signal by sampling every affix of the period of time. And we can take it point by point like this. And here the final result that we get from the 3-bit ADC. Once again, 000 represent the minimum value, and 111 here represent the maximum value. The minimum value can be 0 volt, and the maximum value can be 3.3 volt. Now let's take the bigger one, the 4-bit ADC. Its output composed of 16 steps that start from 0000 to 1111. In the digital world, as we know, 10 to 15 here are represented by A to F. In our system here, the ADC of the microcontroller that we use comes with the 10-bit ADC. It has 1024 different values start from 0 to 1023. The 0 represent the minimum value and 1023 represent the maximum value. The 1024 steps here represent the input voltage that varying from 0 volt to 3.3 volt in our system. These 1024 values are enough to obtain the very very small changes of the input voltage, in this case the varying voltage that come from sensors. Okay, very very long story about the ADC. Hopefully you clearly understand the concepts of the ADC. Now, let's consider the microcontroller board that we have here. On the microcontroller board, once again, there are four potentiometers. We call port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3. The four potentiometers here are connected to the power supply, 3.3 volt, and another side connected to the ground. With this connection, the output voltage that apply to the MCU pins can be vary from 0 volt to 3.3 volt. Remember, these pins of the MCU are internally connected to the 10-bit ADC module. It means that the CPU in the MCU knows that 0 is 0 volt and 1023 is 3.3 volt. Okay, before move into the programming section, let's make an understanding of event data structure of the ADC. There are two types of the event data structure. The first one is the event data structure that used as an on-changes data structure. This data structure will be sent to our application when the MCU detects the changes of voltage at the potentiometer or at the pin that connected to the potentiometer. And the second one is the simple data structure. It looks like this. This data structure will be used for the normal request. What it means by that? It means that when you want to know the value of the ADC, you have to make a request to the CPU and wait there for the response data from the CPU. Now let's see the details of the on-changes data event structure. This data event structure composes of 5 key value pairs. The first one is the UID. The UID here represents the ID or the channel of the ADC. It can be 0, 1, 2, and 3. Because in our system we have 4 channels of the ADC. The second one is the value of the ADC. This value is the 10-bit ADC value. The possible values can be 0 to 1023. As we know, 0 represent 0 volt and 1023 represent 3.3 volt. The third key value pair here, it is the delta. What it mean by delta? Delta means the value that represent the difference of the value between the current value and the previous value. The fourth one here is the direction of the change. What it mean by that? If the value is increased, the direction will be plus 1. It means that it increases up. And if the value is decreased, the direction will be minus 1. It means it decreases down. The last one is the error information. If there are some error, this value will be contains the detail of that error. We can take it and print to check what happened. Now let's take a look to the on-response event data structure. This type of data structure contains only three key value pairs, the UID, the value, and the error. These three key value pairs here represent the same thing that we discussed before. Like the event data structure of the switches that we have discussed in the previous video. These two event data structures will be sent to our callback function in the JavaScript, and we can take all the things there. Okay, now let's open up the VS Code and write some code to make more understanding. Okay, now I am already prepared my working environment. The VS Code already open here. The Chrome browser and the circuit simulator. Currently, it already running here. And back to our VS Code here, and in the examples here, in the apps and in the web apps, let I duplicate this folder by right click and copy, then click on the web app, right click and paste there. Then rename this directory to be adc_gauge. Because we will talking about the ADC and gauge, right? So, as always in the index.html here, nothing to change because we just require the libraries here. And everything will be in the main.js. For the style.css here, nothing there. And in the main.js, I will clear all the things. Okay, now first of all, go to the index.html and right click and open with live server. Okay, to open our application here, go to the main.js here, and we will start with the main function. Let's create gauge object by using the new keyword followed by class name. In this case, the gauge. Okay, hit save. In this time, you will see the gate like this. Okay, the default one. The black background and the white text. And a scale like this. The minimum value is 0 and the maximum value is 100. And currently, it display 50. Okay, you can create a new one by duplicate this line. For example, like this, you get 4 of them, right? Something like that. Okay, that is. It means that this application already work. Now let's create the main object of our application, the link, the WS link, right? Okay, the WS link, as you know, it requires some parameter and an object. In this case, object represented by the curly bracket like this, right? And we can make a new line. Then I remove the space here. Okay. The key value pair in this object, in this video, we are focused on the thing called ADC callback. Because when you make something change on the hardware, I mean on the potentiometers here, this callback will be called. This callback defined in the key name called ADC callback, and you have to give it a function. In this case, I will use the arrow function. As you know, arrow function composed of bracket equal greater than and curly bracket. This we call the arrow function. The event data structure parameters will be passed into this input parameter of this function, right? And you know the first one is UID. The second one is value. Let I call it in short var, just like that. The third one is the delta. The fourth one is the direction. Let I call it dir in short. And the last one is the error. You can give it any name. You can, for example here, if you don't want to give it a full name, you can use the can be x, can be y, whatever. Okay, to save space, I will use the short name, just like a war, just like a dir, just like a err, like that. In the function body here, in the curly bracket here, let's make a new line and check the result by console.log, log all the parameters here. Let I remove this. Okay, and then hit save. After you finish your program for the first time, remember you have to run the ECC UART WebSocket. Okay, to do so, just go to the terminal and new terminal. By default, I use the git bash here. Now, in this time, I will switch to another by click on the down arrow here and select the default shell. I choose the default one of the window, in this case, the CMD. After that, I will remove and restart, reopen it again. See, you get the default one. To run that application, you can input its name, the long name here, ecc-uart-websockets-cli-comp-com-number-3, hit enter. Just like that. Now let's check the result on the web browser by going to the web browser and then hit F12 to open the console window. The first thing to note that I change the library a little bit and right now it's version 1.0.2. Okay, be sure you download the new one. As I told you before, when something change, I will change this number. To be sure you use the last version, check this number. And now to test it, be sure your simulator is running and make some changes on the potentiometer here. For example, I will decrease this value of the port number 0 by click here. See? It tells you that the port number 0 is changes. This is the value, right? This is the delta. This is the direction. Minus 1 mean decrease because I decrease on the potentiometer. Let's try another one. For example here, port number 3. I change up a little bit here. See? It change continuously and tell you the information. For example here, number 3. This is the current value. This is the delta 1. The different value. And the direction is the positive mean increase. You can see this is the greater than this one, right? It means that it increased up. You can click this arrow up down here to decrease 1% at a time. And you see something slowly change, see? Around 1 or 2% depend on how long you click here. Okay, that is about the callback function of the ADC. Now let's back to our course again and let's see how we can change the display of the gauge here to be display the value of the ADC. First of all, let's I cut this line and paste on top here and give it the variable name, the gauge number 1 equal to the gauge class like this. It means that I will use this variable later. That's the reason why I create a new object and put into the variable name here. Okay, and then the gauge composed of many functions, just like a button that you can do something about it. And we know that the gauge designed to display something. Let's try to be sure it works. The gauge number 1, to change its value, you can use the function name called set value. For example, 82, something like that. Okay. When you save, you can see the gate will change to number 82 of 10. Hit save. See? That's it. Later, this number not a constant number, but we will use the value that sent from the potentiometer from the hardware, right? To do that, let's cut this line and put here in the callback function. And we know that the value that sent from the microcontroller will be the value, right? Let I comment here. The value that we have can be 0 to 1023, right? But in this time our gate, we want to display from 0 to 100 in terms of percent, right? Something like that. So We would like to display that number, I mean this number, 0 to 1023. And I would like to display in the scale of 0 to 100. How to do? Just a simple scaling, right? How to do that? Let I call it here, for example, percent equal to the value that we have, right? Here, the VAL. To scale to the percent in this case, scale 0 to 1023 to be the 0 to 100. You can multiply by 100 and divide by the maximum value, in this case the 1023. Now this percent you get 0 to 100, right? And this time you can display this variable on the gauge. Let's try. When you hit save, nothing change here, because once again this function will be called when you make something change on the hardware. Let I move this to almost 0, see, around 6% here, it display 6. When I move up to near 100, see, around 93%, you get almost the same thing. Don't worry about around 1-3% that the display will different. There are two reasons. The first one is we have some error about the component on the simulator. And the second one, I mean the main reason, it come from the calculation in the microcontroller. Because the microcontroller check the delta value, if it see that they are a little bit different, it not update. It mean that it make nothing. For example here, when I make just a 1% change here, change from 93 to 91. If it change a little bit, just like a 1% or something like this, the CPU ignore that change. However, we can adjust that behavior later. Don't focus on a little bit of different number on the potentiometer and the gauge. For example here, 27 and 28. Don't worry, we will fix it later using another function of the library. Okay, now let's play around and just click potentiometers here and see what happens. Now let's see the code in the callback function a little bit here. As you know, we have 5 parameters here. The useful one for you here, the error message here. You have to check every time when you receive the packet or the event when the callbacks are executed. We know that if there are no error, this parameter or variable will be null, right? So you have to check every time. If that error equal to nothing or now mean no error, after that you can apply some mathematic operation here. Did save for your program. Why you have to check? For some reason, for example, when something wrong in the communication between the MCU and the web socket, I mean in the real world, no internet connection. And when we make a request and no response back, it means that they are time out. This value, perhaps it can be a number, I mean can be a random number. If the worst case, if that number, for example, if that number go to another, that not, for example, just like a random text like that. When you try to calculate this without checking, for example here, I will remove the error checking here. And I try to multiply the hello or anything here. Can be any number because we cannot predict, right? When you try to multiply this number with not number, you get undefined or not a number in the programming world. Let's try on the gate. See? Not a number. Okay. If this value go to another thing that not a number, this error will be filled by another. For example, the CPU will send something like this to you. For example, timeout. Or perhaps it send something like this, err overflow or something like that to you. And when this happen, it means that this error is not null. It means that this main operation not executed and your program is safe. Okay, you can check by console log just like that and show the error. Let's try. For example here, we simulate that something wrong in our system. We force that value to the error parameters here. Sure, this if not executed, but in the else will be executed. You will get this message on the console. Let's see. See? Okay, that is the note. My note that I have to tell you. If the designer or the programmer who create that library gives you an error, you have to check the error because he know that sometimes the error can happen in our system. Okay, that it for the error checking. For the delta and the dir, I think you can check, you can utilize it if you like. For example, if you would like to check that value is increase up or decrease down, you can check the dir. For the delta, you can check, okay, you can check on this as well if you like. Okay, that is for the note about the callback. Let I clean up everything here. And now let's talking a bit about the detail of the gate creation here. When you see on the gate here, you see the default one that has the minimum value to 0, the maximum value to 100. When you would like to display something, you have to scale to fit that scale, right? I mean to fit 0 to 100. But if you would like to display the value from the ADC, for example here, I want to display the raw data that sent into the value here, I can do this. But when you try to display on the gauge here, you get something not make any sense, and sometimes you get not a number because it is overflow, right? You pass a bigger number to the gate that just receive only 100, you get something wrong. To show that, you can do by do some fine tunings on the gate creation here. Okay, to do so, you can pass an object. And inside that object, you can pass some key value pairs. For example, if you would like to change the maximum value of the gate to be another, in this case to be 1023, you can pass the key of max and the value is 1023. When you hit save, you get something interesting here. Okay, there are a lot of number on our gauge. Don't worry, we can adjust it later. To do that, we can pass the thing called ticks, the major tick and the minor tick. Let's see. Let's start from the major first. Its key name is ticks. Major. And you can pass. You have here around 0 to around 1000 here, right? If you would like to make some 10 step, for example, your step size should be 100, right? It means that from 0 to 1000, your step size is 100. It means that you have 10 steps, right? Let's save and let's check. See? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. That's the major ticks. You can call that number of digit, okay? Or number of the big one here, the big scale. The big step. Another thing that you can adjust is the line here, the small step here. Okay, you can do that. For example, if you would like to be two step between 0 to 100, you can give it the key of the ticks minor, tick minor, to be the step size from 0 to 100. if you give it 50 you get two step right 0 50 and 100 let's see and if you like to give it five step for example you can do this way the last step in this case 100 right you can give it 100 because it's the last step and you divide by 5 to get the small step and you get 5 small step here between the number okay that's it I think for this play our ADC here let's I step size to 200 and let's see okay looking good and this one can be replaced by a constant if you like for example this one can be 40 right it can be same thing another thing that I can tell you in this point here the color of the number on the scale or on the gauge here currently it white right you can change using the class name of the bootstrap as well just like what time that you learned beforeTo do that, just give it the class name of, for example, if you would like to turn to green, you can give the value of success. And when you save, you get the green one, right? And if you would like to get the red one to pass danger. I have one more special class name here called yellow. Yellow is not the class name of the bootstrap.But I just add it to make something interesting like this. You can if you like. Okay. Info is the bootstrap class as well. Now let's move to the callback function here. We already changed it to display the raw data from the microcontroller. And we know that this value start from 0 to 1023. Now let's make some changes on our circuit and see the result is correct or not.See okay it did play the correct thing in this point you can see our gauge respond to all the potentiometers here sometimes you would like to make it respond to only the gauge number 2 for example once again in this time the UID come to playYou can check if the UID equal to 2 and then just update the gate. You can do that. Okay. Just that way. And see, it respond to number 2. For another, it do nothing. See, I change another. It not change. Because we check that if the UID equal to 2, we do update here.Okay, now you get an idea about using the gate. Just play around and let's see how many things you can think. And don't forget to play about the delta and the DIR. Now, let's go to make something interesting here. As you can see here, we have 4 potentiometers and only 1 gate here. This is a good time to create.4 gate to be display the value of the port here one by one I mean the port 0 display on one gate and the port 1 display on another gate something like that now let's try to create 4 gate and display them one by one how to do that let I copy this first and then comment this okayAfter that, I will create a new here. And let's I clean up another thing in the callback first here. And in the main, let's create the class name as an array here. Let I call it CLS, short from classes. Equal to array of the class name, we have 4.Right. For example, the first one should be success. The second one warning. The third one info. And the last one danger. We have 4 element of the array here. You can use the for loop over this array. You can use for it. You can use map, whatever you like. For me, once again, I love to use the map. Okay, and cls.map. The map is a function of the array, right? And the map receive an argument and an callback function. You can pass a function. You can pass an arrow. In this time, I pass an arrow function here. Arrow composed of the bracket equal to greater than and curly bracket like this, right? And the first argument that pass from the map is the element, indicate the element here. Succeed warning info and danger. And the second one is the index of that element. Once again, the index of that element start from 0. Yeah, this one should be 0, this one 1, and this one 2, and the last one is 3 in this example. It means that we can take both value and the index through the C and the I variable here. Now, let's make a new line. To create the gauge here, we can use this function, right? Let I cut this lines and paste into the map function here. Okay, and this one I use it just gauge. We create the gauge with the maximum value to be 1023. You can pass min if you like. Okay, by default the min is 0. And for the class name here, I will change to be the C in this case, right? Just like that. Let's try. Save and see the result here. You get the gate on a web page, the four items. Start from the success, the clean, right? The warning, the info, and the danger. And once again, to map between the hardware, you can see the number 0 in this case on the right hand side. But if you link to the index of the array here, the 0 on the left hand side, right? To make it easier to refer to, you can pass UID and the reverse order, right? UID of the gate should be 3 minus I, right? It means that this line can be 3, 2, 1, and 0. And now your gate has its ID that map to the port. It means that the left hand side here has an ID 3. 3, 2, 1, and 0. And you can see compared to the hardware, you have port number 3, 2, 1, and 0. And that's it. We will use the UID later to link to that array of the gate. Now the gate is created and saved into that gauge variable. And I want to save all the thing, all the gauge created here. I mean four gauge here. To do so, I create an array called gauge here equal to empty array first. Okay. And after that, when gate here created in the map function here, I will put that gate to the gauge array here. To do that, we can use the function of the array called push. In this case, the gauge dot push. Which one is you would like to put in this case? Sure, the gate that we just created. It means that this line will be executed 4 times. Start from succeed, warning, info, and danger. Once again, if you would like to see what happened with the gauge array here, you can console.log and see the progressive of the gauge here. See, on the console, you can see the first time it had only one gauge, the second time two gauge, the third and the fourth one. Okay, that is for the gauge. Later, we can refer to the gauge, right? Let I clean up a little bit here. Now, let's working about update the value of the gauge here on the web page. As we know, when the potentiometer are changed, the callback will be called, right? And first of all, let's review. This is the same idea compared to the switched that we learned before. First of all, we have to check the UID. Okay, by console log. In this time, when you change the gate number 3, you get 3, right? Many times here, when you change number 0, you get 0. It means that this value is correct. Once again, 0 means gate 0 in this case on the right hand side because we define it as a UID. Don't see on the array because the array starts from 0 on the left hand side, right? But we guarantee that this correct from the UID. Now, we know that the good practice is we have to check there are no error by checking that variable err. If that err equal to null mean no error, you can do something here. In this case, we would like to update the gate, right? The gate in this time store in the gate array. Now, let's do it. Gauge at the position of, let I call the variable name idx, we will create later, dot set value. The value that we would like to set is that the value that part from the microcontroller, right? In this case, the VL. And let's think about the idx. Idx should be, what you think? 3 minus UID. Right? Let's try it correct or not. I will change the potentiometer number 3 here. See? Only number 3 is changed here. See? When I change number 1 only will change. That's it. We can control the display of the gate that link to the hardware. Okay, interesting here. Okay, just play around and you can change it quickly here, yeah, in the same time. It will send because we check an ID. Hopefully this helps and you can apply this to your project. Okay, your project perhaps composed of just only one or two. You can change this depend on your application. Okay, now let's talking a little bit about the system behavior here. I have here the project is running, okay, and when you hit the refresh on the web page, you can see all the gauge here start from the middle where you, but actually the potentiometers here not in the middle, right? Some is very high, some is very low here, but the gauge did play the wrong thing. Because when you hit a refresh, nothing to update. It means that the microcontroller send nothing to our web page. That's a reason why. But however, when you restart the microcontroller, I mean restart the simulator here, I stop and then run again. See on the gate here. See? On the start time, the microcontroller will send that data, the current data, to the gauge. Okay, let's see one more time here. Yeah, I will stop and then I change number 3 to very low value and number 0 to very high value here. Let's see, this is the initial point, right? When I click run, see? Number 3 will go low and number 0 go high. Okay, that's the thing that you have to think about when you try to use this system. Another thing that you have to know about this system is when you make a small change, for example, you click on the arrow here. Sometimes it doesn't change because the CPU waiting for the big change, in this case, around 20 initially. We can change that value, I tell you later. Now let's see on the output window here. Yeah. I will make the small change on the port number 3 here. You see on this window here. When I make a small change, Okay. See, that only change here. Wait more, this is the 44, right? Let's increase a bit. 25, nothing change here. One more. See, you can see that on the delta here around 20, 21, something like that. If the delta, I mean the current value compared to the previous one is greater than 20, the MCU will detect that change and send the data to the web browser. Okay. However, this parameter can be changed if you like. Now, let's see how to change it. This is the additional function that perhaps it can help you to make things more easier to set up to fit to your project. That function we call the ADC set auto detection. It is the function of the link here. Let me show you here. In this time, I would like to see the change that only 5. Previously, the delta is 20, right? The minimum value is 20. Now I will change to 5. Let's see how to do that. We have the link object here. And to do so, let I refer to that variable and call it function called ADC set auto detection. Just like that. The first parameter is the channel ID. In this case, I will focus on channel number 3. That a UID. It means that the port number 3 in this case. And the next parameter is that change step, that delta value that allows MCU to see that change, in this case that 5. And for the third parameter, you can change as well to ask CPU to check it how long. For example, 1 second, something like that. First of all, let's focus on the number 3 because we focus on it. Once again, let's focus on this window here. Let I make a small change here. See? Compared to the previous one, you can see the delta should be greater than 20, right? But in this time, just greater than 5, and then CPU will respond to that change. See, just only one click, only 1%, it respond you, because that number can control. That it. And you can change all of them by change this ID from 0, 1, 2, and 3. I prefer around 10% of the maximum value. In this case, we have around 1,000, right? You have to make a change around, I think, 10% of 1,000, just 100. Okay? Be careful about this value because if you make it very, very small in the real world, I mean, the MCU will detect it, the change continuously, and it will send that data to the internet continuously. It means that you have to use a very, very large bandwidth. Your internet must be fast enough to transfer that data. However, this I just tell you about how to make some tuning about that parameter, about that function. Once again, the first one is the UID of the port or the ID. The second one is the delta value that tell the MCU, hey, please send me when you see the change greater than that value, we call delta. And the third one is the time that tell the MCU, hey, you have to check the change every 1 second, 2 second, or 5 second, or something like that. For example here, if I change this to 5, it means that the CPU will check that change every 5 second. Okay, I call this interval. Let's see about the port number 0 here, because I would like to check it every 5 seconds. And when hit save, you can see on this window again, focus on number 0, okay? I will change. See, nothing happened until you get 5 seconds, and then you get there. Okay, let's make change again. You can see I will make the change continuously here. But the data will send to your internet every 5 seconds. Okay, I am still make the change here. See? you get this data from the channel 0 every 5 seconds. That's the thing that you have to understand the behavior of the system. Sometimes it can simulate the situation that fit to your project. Okay, just keep in mind and use it if you like. But for me, the default one mean nothing to use. I mean, if you don't put this line in your system, it still work correctly that you see before. But however, if you would like to make some changes on that, you can. Okay, that's it for this video. For the next video, we just change from the gate to the plotter. The plotter means the thing that can draw the line on the screen, just like an oscilloscope. Okay, see you in the next video. Take care and goodbye.